Well done, Claire. Now for a true insight into the goings-on within the Cassells house. I'd like to call on Eamon Cassells Jnr, please.
She's a saint. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, dinosaurs of the opposition. It's with great pleasure I stand before you tonight to propose the motion that that a bachelor's life is happier than that of a married man. Now, before I go any further, I'd like to look at some points made by the opposition here tonight. Eamon tells us that it's about his long bachelorhood. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this can only be a figment of his imagination for two reasons. A, that was a long, long, long time ago. And B, at his age, the old memory gets a bit dodgy and you can't really trust it. So I'm guessing that he's just making up an elaborate story there. He can't remember what his bachelorhood was like. But I guarantee you, ladies and gentlemen, it was a happy one. Then we have Claire. Come back to Claire, let's look at Charlie first. Charlie tells us the time comes that you have to leave bachelorhood behind. There comes a time you have to leave the freedom, the fun, the happiness behind. Just because you have to do something, ladies and gentlemen, doesn't make you happy. I had to get a filling the other day. That didn't make me happy. Now, maybe there does come a time that you have to do it, but it doesn't mean you're going to be any happier after you get married. Now we have Claire. And Claire, unlike her teammates, is a happy woman. She's a very happy person. The reason for that is because she's the one in control. I look at Brian sitting beside her. And he is not shackled with chains as she'd spoken, because he's ruled with an iron fist. Claire had the audacity to suggest that Raj wasn't married enough for her. And that he was only partially married.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he has the bit of paper, therefore he is married.
Yes, absolutely.
And he was made all the less happy for it.
Was the piece of paper in the bed?
And Claire, Anto, really happy to sample the wares of Doran's on a Saturday night. If you have the same dinner every night of the week, you're going to be fairly unhappy. Variety is the spice of life. And Charlie told us earlier, that no permission was sought or offered for his wife's film career. Why is that, ladies and gentlemen? Because she's the one in control. She's the boss, and we have no doubt about that whatsoever. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at an Irish institution. Bachelor's beans. Now, look at the kind of bachelor's beans. There's two lads on the can of bachelor's beans. Hey, look at them, they're smiling. They're delighted. Why are they delighted? Because they're bachelors. They're able to go, and they're able to consume the contents of the said can of beans. Now, if you're a married man, or anyone, as you know, eating a can of beans has a certain effect on the digestive system. Now, if you're a married man, you have to worry about the effects of that when you're sharing a bed with your wife. These two lads don't have to worry about that at all, and they are perfectly happy. It's proving the point that the life of a bachelor is far happier than that of a married man.
Thank you, Jackson, you're
now to the science part. Now to the science part. Biologically speaking, we aren't set up for this whole monogamy thing. The natural state to play is to go out on a Saturday night and sow your wild oats. Then go to Mass on a Sunday morning and pray for crop failure. Thanks to scientific advances, the average Irish male can expect to live well into his late 80s. 60-odd years, ladies and gentlemen, is far too long to spend with a single person, no matter how sound they might be. The fact is that 60 years with one person is going to end up with you being just mightily annoying person. By definition, a bachelor is younger than... Let me finish this point and then I'll sit down.
Right.
By definition, a bachelor is younger than a married man. since you must be a bachelor before you're a married man. As we were often told by the older generation, that our youth is the happiest days of our life. Therefore, the youthful exploits that we have as a bachelor makes us so much happier, proving that the life of a bachelor is far happier than that of a married man. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
I'd now like to call on Brian O'Reilly to put his end forward for the opposition. Here you are,
Mr. Chairman, members of the proposition, and Athboy Macra, I want to thank you for giving me a second opportunity in my 17 years of marriage to get the opportunity to speak after my wife, and what she cannot refute me. So thank you to Athboy Macra.
Happiness.
First of all, I want to thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Eamon's last comment there was that 60 years was too long to spend with one person. Would I give him a bit of advice? If he wants to find that out, he better move soon, because he won't have 60 years with one person if some of you women down there don't grab him. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there is one person on the other team that has experience of marriage. And he stood up there tonight and he told us all he was looking for divorce. What is divorce? It is a thing that we in this country, most of the people in this country voted for. Because divorce is only one thing. People who made the mistake the first time want a second chance. Those that got married and made a mistake know that marriage is far better than bachelorhood, and they want divorce. Raj wants divorce because divorce will give him the chance to have a happy life, to get married again. If he doesn't get divorced, he will have to remain a bachelor for the rest of his life in misery. He stood up here tonight and told you all he wanted a divorce so he could get married again. Ladies and gentlemen, Eamon said. Now, the intelligence of the people on the other side, Eamon stood up here tonight and he said that he went and got a filling and that he was not happy about it. Ladies and gentlemen, he's only thinking of short term. The reason he got a filling was he wanted more happiness. He didn't want to be living in pain. He wanted to get rid of the pain and live a happy life. The same as, if he has any sense, he will experience bachelorhood. And then he will experience marriage, and he will find out that it's an awful lot better. We have divorce in this country. We brought it in, and everybody thought that people would be getting divorced right, left and centre. The only people that got divorced in this country are the small, single-figure percentage that made a mistake. The vast majority of people, well over 90% of people in this country, remain married. The reason they remain married is, even though they have the opportunity to change their lifestyle, they don't want it, they stay married.
No,
and as my wife has already pointed out, excuse me, if you want to debate, you're going to put up here and debate. My wife, there are no chains on any of us men. We have stood up here today in front of you and none of us have rattled. Ladies and gentlemen, we are not chained to marriage. We have the choice to get divorced.
Take out some of
now, Martha has already stood up there tonight and told us that she's an intelligent woman, that she has a bachelor's degree in something or another. But the other thing that she told us was that she intended finding a husband. That she told us that that God help her poor husband because he'd have no TV, he'd have no GAA, and he'd have a couple of more three-letter words he wouldn't have. But she, in her intelligence, ladies and gentlemen, stood up here in front of you and told us that she was going to make a man happy. She was going to find a husband and get married to him because she knew there was some of you poor unfortunate bachelors down there that wanted something better out of life. You wanted marriage to her to have a better life. Ladies and gentlemen, would Martha stand up here and put you in misery? No, the only reason she wants to get married is that she wants another man to be happy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Anthony. Anthony stood up earlier tonight and told us he was 20 years old. Yeah. And now he stands up and he tells us he's experienced. Ladies and gentlemen, most of us on this team have more experience than him as bachelors and more experience of him than married. I'm the least married person here today. They have 17 years of married life. Almost as long as he's in existence in this world. 30 years of bachelor's life before that, ladies and gentlemen. We have the experience. Eamon there has 30 or 40 years of bachelor experience and another similar of married life. Charlie has, I don't know how many roses of married life and years of experience of bachelorhood. We have the experience, we are standing up. They have only experience on one side. Any intelligent person will look at both sides of the argument, will experience both sides of the argument before they come here today and preach to you what you should do. We here have experienced both sides, and all four of us here are willing to come here and say, with the experience we have, with knowing what bachelor hall is like, with knowing what married life is like, we stand in front of you and say, married life is better. Vote with us. Thank you.